way to connect with the food that I eat and the food that I put on the table for my family. It's not about pulling the trigger, as I said, but don't get me wrong, it does make, you know, the deal even more sweeter when you come back and you've got a carcass to prepare and then to feed your family and your friends. It's not the be-all and end-all, and I don't get bitter or upset if I don't come back with something afterwards. And I think that's what a lot of people sometimes forget and should be reminded of.
To me, there's something quite special about being able to hunt for your own meat and to be able to go into the freezer and know exactly where that animal has come from and to be able to cook with that. Like I say, it's something that is really special.
But also it's about the story. I think so much of what hunting and cooking wild game has become for me is inviting people over and sharing it and passing that meat on. I've had a couple of lucky seasons where I've had very large animals that I've been able to take. And so the cool part of that is that I'm able to give so much meat away to my friends that can then take it and pass it on and try new recipes and share those stories with other people.
Yeah, I think there's a misperception about the skill involved in hunting. A lot of people think it's such an advantage to have a gun in your hand over a free-range animal. There's really so much work done before you even get out of the truck or before you even get to the field in terms of preparation and practice and understanding the weapon that you're holding. Skills as far as orienteering and understanding the landscape and where you are, where animals are, where their habitat is.
I think preparedness is key, like with most things, where, you know, making sure that you've got the right equipment, you're wearing the right equipment, you're going with people that are also like-minded and respectful, and you've been as ethical as possible in the fact that you've made sure your rifle's zeroed, you've made sure that you've practiced again and again and again at the range, ensuring that everything is hunky-dory, so the only thing that will be a limiting factor is human error. You know, everyone's gonna get those days now and again where you're a bit shaky or you're a bit nervous or, you know, the adrenaline is kind of kicking in and things don't go to plan. Of course that does happen and you'd be a fool to pretend it doesn't. But to try and eliminate any other error by human error, by, you know, making sure you've got the right equipment, making sure that you're with someone that really knows the land, if it's not your own land.
Overall, I think the biggest skill is mental and understanding that your goal is really to take a life. And so with that comes a certain amount of responsibility to have all of both the physical and mental skills in place before you even start.
I just wanted everything to be right for you today, yeah. You know, so.
No, thank you.
The time and
I think a lot of people get scared off by the fact that it is game meat, but this week we've proved alone
that we've had venison bolognese, we've had venison curry, venison Wellington, and tonight we're going to have venison pie.
You know, from the point of cull all the way through to it being on your plate, the processes that it's gone through. You've made sure before by checking glands and whatever that it's a healthy animal. And then you know the land it's been living off, you know what it's been eating. You can literally check inside and make sure you know what it's been eating. So that is, I can't think of a more healthy and pure way of getting your food.
In this country, it is very quick for people to criticise your decision to hunt. People are so far removed from where their meat comes from. So I think we have the responsibility to educate people.
I personally haven't had a lot of experience with someone telling me that they think hunting is wrong or that they're anti-hunting, but in this industry that certainly exists and you will encounter it at some point. And I've had a lot of conversations with people who I would just say are non-hunters that are at least open-minded enough to have the conversation about finding out why I chose to hunt. And those are the best conversations. I think a lot of times it comes down to education and ignorance or just lack of knowing what hunting really is. And there's a lot of bad PR out there, admittedly, for hunters. And I think part of, unfortunately or not, like part of our responsibility as hunters is to portray what hunting really is and what it should be about.
It's frustrating because I think a lot of the time it's the wrong side of hunting that gets portrayed in the media, and I do get it why, because it's a shock factor. Everyone's like, oh my gosh, what has this person done? That's disgusting behaviour. And quite frankly, I agree with a lot of it. You know, a lot of it is disgusting behaviour, a lot of it is disrespectful, and a lot of it I also don't agree with. But I'd love to take out a proper anti-hunter on one of my hunts, and I don't think there's much they could disagree with.